Following Hungarian Prime Minister Viktor Orbán's statements against Poland, Polish Deputy Foreign Minister Teofil Bartoszewski expressed doubt about Hungary's membership in the EU and NATO. The Polish Deputy Foreign Minister emphasized that, unlike Orbán, his country does not do business with Russia after the full-scale invasion of Ukraine, because it was an attack on Poland, the United States, the EU, and NATO. Bartoszewski emphasized that Orbán's speech has already been commented on very negatively by the U.S. Embassy in Budapest. I don't really understand why Hungary wants to remain a member of organizations that they dislike so much and that allegedly treat them badly. Why doesn't Orbán ally with Putin and other authoritarian states? It's based on the idea that if you don't want to be in a club, you can just leave. This is definitely Hungary's anti-European, anti-Ukrainian, anti-Polish policy at this time. Bartoszewski reminded that Hungary is also blocking 2 billion zlotys, 467 million euros, from the European Peace Fund, which was intended for Poland from the EU to compensate for military equipment received by Ukraine. The day before, during a keynote speech at the Tuszvanyos Summer University in the Romanian resort town of Belei Tusnad, the Hungarian Prime Minister said that the Poles are leading the most hypocritical and sanctimonious policy in all of Europe because they allegedly, shamelessly do business with Russia. Relations between Warsaw and Budapest have cooled since Russia's invasion of Ukraine in February 2022 due to differences in attitudes toward the invasion. However, before the speech, Orbán also said that the Poles were no longer good at kicking the Polish ass, which was also a quote, and that Hungarians had had enough of it. Until that moment, Orbán had not allowed himself to make such harsh statements about Warsaw. That is, these were openly anti-Polish statements on Orbán's part. But meanwhile, the decision of U.S. President Joe Biden to withdraw from the election race significantly increased expectation rating and liking rating for Kamala Harris. It has significantly increased. Vice President Harris's approval rating in the United States rose to 43%, while 42% disapprove of her. Last week, before Biden announced his withdrawal from the election, these figures were 35% and 46%, respectively. The number of people who don't support her has decreased. Most notable is the increase in favorability for the U.S. vice president among independents, i.e. those who do not support the Republican or Democratic Party, from 28% to 44%, while disapproval fell from 47% to 40%. In general, 52% of American voters support the nomination of Kamala Harris as a presidential candidate from the Democratic Party. In the same ABC News poll, the approval rating of U.S. Republican presidential candidate Donald Trump dropped from 40% to 36% over the week.